Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Old Ways, which I found here in the dungeons of Sentinel Castle. The Old Ways, the Customs and Philosophy of Grave and Faithful Council. We who know the old ways are well aware of the existence of a spiritual world invisible to the unenlightened. Just as one living in a kingdom but unaware of the political machinations may see a new tax or battle preparation as capricious fortune, many observe floods, famines, and madness with helpless incomprehension. This is deplorable. As the great Kulian Darnazan moaned, the power of ignorance can truly shatter mithril like glass. What, after all, is the origin of these spiritual forces that move the invisible strings of Mundus? Any neophyte of Arteum knows that the spirits are our ancestors, and that, while living, they too were bewildered by the spirits of their ancestors, and so on to the original Archaeae. The Daedra and gods the common people turn to are no more than the spirits of superior men and women whose power and passion granted them great influence in the Phantom World. Certainly, this is our truth and our religion, but how does it help us in our sacred duty to Silifrinase, or provide grave and faithful counsel? Firstly, we can easily grasp the necessity of both bringing good men great power and making powerful men good. We recognize the multiple threats that a strong tyrant represents. He breeds cruelty, which feeds the Daedra Boethia, and hatred, which feeds the Daedra Vernima. If he should die performing a particularly malevolent act, he may go to rule in oblivion. Worst of all, he inspires other villains to power and other rulers to villainy. Knowing this, we have developed patience in our dealings with such despots. They should be crippled, humiliated, impoverished, imprisoned. Other counselors than we may advocate assassination or warfare, which, aside from its spiritual significance, is expensive, aleatric, and likely to cause at least as much pain to innocents as the brutish dictator was inflicting. No, we are intelligence gatherers, dignified diplomats, not revolutionaries. How then are our counselors faithful? We are faithful only to the old ways. It is essential always to remember the spiritual world in watching our world. Performing the rites of Moita on the second of Hearthfire and the Vigild on the first of Second Seed are essential means of empowering the salutary ghosts and debilitating the unclean spirits. How then are we faithful to those we counsel and to the Isle of Arteum? Perhaps the sage Tahirite said it best. In Mundus, conflict, disparity is what brings change, and change is most sacred of all the 11 forces. Change is the force without focus or origin, and it is the duty of the disciplined Sijic, enlightened one, to dilute change where it brings greed, gluttony, sloth, ignorance, prejudice, cruelty. Tahirite lists the ill prodigalities. And to encourage change where it brings excellence, beauty, happiness, and enlightenment. As such, the faithful council has but one master, his mind. If the man the Sijic counsels acts wickedly and brings Ognathir, bad change, and will not be counseled, it is the Sijic's duty to counterbalance the Ognathir by any means necessary. A student of the old ways may indeed vassal himself to a lord, but it is a risky relationship. Should the lord refuse wise counsel and order the Sijic, to use Taherite's outmoded word, to perform an act contrary to the teaching of the old ways, there are few available options. The Sijic may abandon his lord, which will bring shame on him and the Isle of Arteum, and so may never be allowed home again. The Sijic may also kill himself. Thanks for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, The Old Ways.